Because the first thing he did when he got off the boat was build an altar and not a new house. He has no crib to go to. He has no school to put his children in. He has no church to go to. He has no job to go to. Because everything's been wiped out. Watch me, church. And he did not prioritize himself in the midst of nothing. He put God first. Because this is the Old Testament prelude to seek ye first. Of heaven and all of his righteousness and all of these things will be added. Maybe when we explore worship, worship has nothing to do with how he healed you, how he blessed you, how he kept you. Worship says you are God all by yourself, even when I had nothing. His worship. Put him first when Noah had nothing. Watch God's response. I'm not there. Watch God's response, church.
Preach it out.
God, in verses 20 and 21, does something interesting. The accredited author of the book of Genesis assigned an anthropomorphic attribute to God. And gave God a nose. It says, and the Lord smelled. God's a spirit. Spirits don't have body parts. But Moses gave him an anthropomorphic attribute and put a nose on a spirit. And it says, and the Lord smelled. Lord have mercy. And the Lord said of sweet singing that while Noah is worshiping in his present nothing, God is responding to his worship. And the Bible says, and the Lord said. It doesn't say, and the Lord said to Noah. It says, and the Lord said. It means, y'all, that Noah worshiped God without hearing a word from God. But just because he worshiped God and didn't hear a word from God does not mean that God was not working for Noah. The Bible says, I see it down there. He put me first. No home, no school, no job. He put me first. Here's what I'm going to do for him. Seed time comes. Summer and winter. Hot and cold. I know we started on his behalf. Y'all missed it. Noah is worshiping and had no word from God. But while Noah was worshiping in the present nothing, God was working on his future son. Can I ask y'all a question? What kind of worship would you give God if your next worship affected the next blessing that God was to do in your life? What kind of worship would you give God if the next praise you gave him was contingent upon the next person he worked with? Just because you don't hear from him doesn't mean he's not working on you. And while you're in your present nothing, he's working on your future, son. Now y'all ask me, have to do, Dr. Clark, with this season that we're in.
Yeah.
I'm glad you asked.
Yes, sir.
If you got a Bible, you can read it. This is God's result. See, in verse 20 and 21, this is what God said. God said, you know what? Because he's down there worshiping me. I'm going to not do this again. I'm not going to destroy the earth again. This is what he said. This is his reason. 8:21 says, I'm not going to destroy them again because of the wickedness in their imagination, which is in them from their youth. That's the way this blessed my life. Because God's reason for not destroying humanity is the same reason why he destroyed humanity. Genesis chapter number 6, verse number 5. The reason why he destroyed humanity is because we were wicked in our imagination.
God built when God sacrificed to save God's
Shoulder. Tell a neighbor, it's time to build you an altar.